My name is Jehu Garcia. I'm a business owner, self-professed engineer, and an overall dreamer. For the past 2 years, I've been building my dream car, something that retains all the elegance of the classic 50s design, but at the same time make up the latest the modern technology offers. Now, how do you exactly do that? By making it electric. Follow me on my journey through all the struggles, the challenges, but ultimately the satisfaction of growth and success. Welcome to another episode of the Electric Samba Project. Whoa, did you guys check out the background behind me? Yeah, we're trying to show some of these trickery, some of these techniques that we've learned along the years in production. We want to start implementing those in here in the show. We also wanted to change a little bit the format. You know, for the past year and a half, you guys been watching me build the Samba, you know, go through all the troubles from inception all the way to installation and, you know, problems and troubleshooting and stuff like that. But the truth is that my inspiration comes from some of the projects that are happening out there, some of your projects. There's a lot of you out there that are building cars and they have ongoing projects for the past few years. And watching your progress has really encouraged me to keep going in the Electric Samba. So even though some of your projects have been featured in other shows before, I want to take the opportunity to showcase those here on my show. So this first video I want to show you is from Chris Carlson. It's one of my favorite. He's from HPEVS Automotive, and he calls his project the Electric Rod. It's a 1937 Chevy Coupe. So the cool thing about Chris's project is, of course, that he's starting with an iconic classic car that will end up being as modern as cars can get. To do that, he's using an HPEVS AC76, which is, of course, a three-phase AC induction motor. His project gets even more interesting once you realize that he plans on powering the vehicle with, yes, you guessed it, recycled 18650 cells extracted from dead laptop batteries. Sound familiar? Well, I for one hope he finishes his project before I finish mine, as I can't wait to see how well his spring-loaded battery box design works. That's right, he's not planning on welding or soldering all those cells together, but instead use springs to load tension and press all 1600 cells together. I can foresee a few challenges in the design, but I would never dare to say it wouldn't work, but instead I'd say, try it and please let us know how it goes. So from time to time, I also want to shed light into some of the other cool projects, like it'd be different, like cars and bikes and motorcycles and stuff like that, that I find interesting. This second project that I want to show you is from a company in Italy called Italjet Moto. Now, this two-wheel contraption strikes my fancy because, again, it has a retro classic look, but it's pretty much a modern vehicle. This particular one is too small to be considered a motorcycle, yet too big to be an e-bike. So it lives right in the middle, just perfect for someone like me that's not fully committed to owning a full-blown motorbike. This is a prototype and not much specs are known at this time, other than it will do a top speed of 50 miles per hour due to a small 250 watt hub motor, and it will have 31 miles of range. I just hope it makes it to production and that it's affordable. So for this next video, from time to time, we also get some cool videos that show the processes, how batteries are made, or sometimes how motors are rewound or stuff like that. There's been one that has been going around for this past few weeks in which they showed you the process, the manufacturing process of the Nissan Leaf batteries. And so I wanted to include it today so that you can see just how easy it is to make batteries. Okay, maybe not so easy. It seems like you need a lot of specialized equipment, a clean room full of automated and robotic arms, making the whole process visually very interesting. Here's the video, enjoy. right, guys, these are the videos that I wanted to share with you this week. If you have an interesting project and you want to share with us, please send it to us. Go to theelectricsamba.com and sign up and submit your video and your link so that I can look it over and then we can share it with the rest of the community. So until next time, stay busy building. Thank you for watching. For more info on the featured stories on this video, make sure to click on the links found on the description section below. Please make sure to comment and share and check out the other series of videos on my channel.